Hi everyone, welcome back to Prakasham Tutorials. In my previous video, we have discussed concept of delta modulation, working principle of delta modulation, delta modulator transmission and delta modulator receiver. Now here in this video, we are going to discuss about disadvantages of delta modulation. Disadvantages of delta modulation and the advantages of delta modulation. It transmits only 1 bit per sample. Delta modulation transmits only 1 bit per sample. Therefore, the signaling rate and the transition channel bandwidth is quite small for delta modulation compared to pulse mode modulation. That is the advantage of the delta modulation. And one of the difference between delta modulation and pulse mode modulation. And the second advantage of the delta modulation is the transmitter and receiver implementation is very much simple for delta modulation. There is no analog to digital converter required in delta modulation. And third advantage of delta modulation is it is a 1 bit quantizer. Delta modulation is a 1 bit quantizer. And fourth advantage is very easy to design of the modulator and the demodulator. And these are the advantages of delta modulation over pulse code modulation. Next, coming to the disadvantages or drawbacks of delta modulation. The delta modulation has two major drawbacks. There are two disadvantages of delta modulation. So that are, first one is slope overload distortion. Slope overload distortion means when the step size value and the step size delta is small. And second drawback is granular noise or ideal noise. So granular noise means when delta is larger value. So now we are going to discuss about slope overload distortion and granular noise. First, we are going to discuss about slope overload distortion. And what is the slope overload distortion? So now here, and this is the in this figure, and this is the message signal or the input signal, and this is the staircase approximated signal, and this is the waveform of the staircase approximated signal, and this is the waveform of the message signal. The slope overload distortion arises because of large dynamic range of the input signal. As can be observed from this figure, the rate of rise of input signal x of t is so high that the staircase output staircase signal cannot approximate it. The step size here, the step size delta, and this is the step size delta. The step size delta becomes too small, and the message signal value is very high, and the step size value is very less. If the step size delta becomes too small, very small, for the staircase signal, hence there is a large error between the staircase approximated signal and input signal. The original input signal x of t. This type of error or this type of noise is called as slope overload distortion. Once again, I will explain the slope overload distortion concept. This slope overload distortion occurs because of large dynamic range of the input signal. As can be observed from this figure, the rate of rise of the input signal the rate of rise of the input signal is so high that the staircase signal cannot approximate it. Now here the step size delta becomes very small, too small for the staircase signal u of t to follow the step segment of the input signal x of t. Hence, there is a large error between the staircase approximated signal and the original input signal x of t. This type of noise is known as slope overload distortion. And how to reduce this slope overload distortion? So to reduce the slope overload error or the slope overload distortion, the step size must be increased. And this is the step size. The step size must be increased. The step size must be increased when slope of the signal x of t is high. Since the step size of delta modulator remains fixed, its maximum or minimum slopes occur along straight line. Therefore, this modulation is also known as linear delta modulation. So this is the reduction of the, this is the process of we can reduce slope overload distortion method. So in this figure we can observe slope overload distortion. Okay, and the same figure I will explain granular noise. So what is the granular noise? Now we have the, in this figure, this is the message signal. In this message signal, this is the message signal. So granular noise occurs when the step size is too large. Compared to small variation in the input signal. Okay, step size is very large compared to small variation in the input signal. This means that for very small variation in the input signal, the staircase signal is changed by large amount of time, large amount, because of large step size. In this figure shows that when the input signal is almost flat, now we have the input signal and this is the message signal or the input signal. Input signal here almost flat, small variation of the input signal. The staircase signal u of t keeps on oscillating by plus or minus delta around the signal. The error between the input signal and the staircase approximated signal is called granular noise. So that is the granular noise definition. Once again, I will explain the granular noise. The granular noise occurs when the step size is too large to a small variation in the input signal x of t, which means that for very small variation in the input signal, the staircase signal is changed by large amount because of large step size. In this figure, we can observe that when the input signal is almost flat, the staircase signal keeps on oscillating by plus or minus delta around the signal. Now, so the error between the input signal x of t and the staircase approximated signal is called as granular noise. How to overcome this type of the noise? The solution of this problem is to make step size small. Reduces the step size. So to reduce the step size, to avoid the granular noise.